explain to me what that wall of Jericho is doing between Ozo and Nengi? What is that wall of Jericho demarcation doing there? I don't understand. Does he have crocro? Abi, does she have crocro? When Gora was there with him, she put demarcation. Nengi too do it and I don't put demarcation. Something is wrong somewhere. Something is wrong. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Austin Beffa. I'm really glad to have you here. Please do want to hit on subscribe button before you leave and also give this video a very big thumbs up at the end if you enjoyed watching it. Okay guys, it is no longer news that Ozo is our head of house for the week and he chose Nengi to be his deputy for the week. So obviously what that means is that both of them will be spending time together in the HOH lounge. Now what I don't understand is why there has to be a demarcation in the first place, but if you think about it again, you will know that just put demarcation before they go come again, bring another story, say you and this boy don't they knock. You guys, I don't know if you saw the post that was making it round on social media about Nengi and Ozo having sex. Guys, that thing is a lie from the pit of hell. Like, I don't know how people just lie like that. And I would not really blame them if they put demarcation. In fact, when I saw the demarcation, I was like, thank you, Lord. Guys, because that picture that made it round on social media, when I saw it, I was like, now the best where they big yells be this, why people they lie like that? Up until they posted it on Nengi's Instagram page, you know, and the post was actually from 2018. I know some of you don't know what I'm talking about, so I went through the stress of sourcing for the picture. Guys, this particular picture has nothing, absolutely nothing to do with Nengi. I get that this person in this picture is light-skinned, but that's obviously not Nengi. There's no bed in Biggie's house that's like that. You guys have seen the kind of beds they have in their rooms. So where did they get this one from? Somebody just went and dug up a picture from a porn site and came out and said it was Nengi. For me, I felt like that was really disrespectful. You want them to say if Nengi and Ozo want knock, they don't know where they go do them. I mean, even if they want to do something like that, it should probably be in the head of house lounge. But then they've not been together in the head of house lounge before now. So how come they had the space to join knock? When we say nobody go enter, nobody go disturb them. I don't know how people just behave. I found that post really disrespectful to Nengi. And as much as I know who made the post, I'm just not going to mention the name here. I know some of you know who it is, but you guys know if I mention them now, my own voice, they go, yeah, they'll carry and go show the person. So better said, I know one problem, you know, but I feel like the person who made that post already apologized. But sometimes, yeah, apology doesn't do the magic. Sometimes the damage has already been done. But we're just really glad that, thank God, all of us will say, not be that kind of bed, they big brother house. So not be them. Not be them, not be Ozo, and not be Nengi. The only problem now be say, even if they want knock, now Kayode no go show us this week. Now that one, they pay me. Kayode no go show us. But they don't already start with demarcation, so I don't know. I don't know what to expect. But wait, first, let me just ask you people, do you think that this is how they'll be demarcating for the next 7 days? It's so funny to me. I mean, you can sleep on the same bed with a guy without necessarily having sex or doing anything, right? I mean, I'm sure they overthink things. Some people actually think that Nengi is camera conscious. Do you guys agree with that theory? Do you think that she's just doing all of these things for the camera? Or do you think that she genuinely wants a demarcation there? Let's just talk in the comment section, okay? Because at this point, all we can do is speculate. We don't even have proof of anything or, you know, I don't just know. I mean, I feel like if they keep putting this demarcation, it's going to be boring. Okay, I need some body warmth, you know, between the ozone ship. I need them to have body warmth. Okay, body warmth not go kill anybody. Body warmth not go kill anybody. Thank you. Anyways, guys, let's talk briefly about the head of house challenge and just how it went down yesterday, because I know that some of you are still dying to hear what happened. Guys, yesterday was quite confusing for me because I don't understand. Prince, it's high time we started doing fasting and prayer for you, because what's happened they pass Gary for your matter. Guys, this boy got to the final spot. I think he got to 29. And I saw Biggie tell him, I'm saying, Prince, the calculation is not right. You have to go back to 16. Now, by the time he went back to 16, he had like a few seconds left. And, you know, he couldn't do so much. It was just so frustrating. Now, when they now left the arena, Tolani Bad did something that got me smiling. You know, she went to sit down with him where he was, because he was really downcast and all of that. And she was like, see, don't worry. Don't worry. Just be optimistic. Next week will be better. Maybe God did not want you to win it because you cannot choose me as a deputy. You guys know that she has a strike and Biggie exempted her from participating this week, so she was just trying to make him smile. She wasn't saying it from a bad place, because she actually mentioned it there to him that she wouldn't have had a problem if Prince had picked Dorothy as his deputy. That's if at all he had won the game. She was just like, don't be upset, you know, you try next week, you know, next week is going to be better, you know, I don't want you to feel bad. I'm like, oh, thank you Tolani for being sensitive to my brother's mood. Guys, it was actually a very romantic side. Now, someone else that got my attention during the game was V. Guys, for the first time in a long time, V got really close to 30. She was at 29 when the buzzer went off. And the thing is that there was a lot of confusion here. 30, 28, you know how the housemates are always counting. So she was even confused, like, am I supposed to go and throw a ball? Because they actually had like 4 hurdles for this particular game. The first one is actually throwing a ball into the basketball net. The second one is using your mouth to blow 2 cups off the table. You know these red cups they used to drink at parties and clubs and all of that stuff? You know, so they're supposed to use their mouth to blow 2 off the table. Then the third one was them folding wrapper. I say, they should come and call me now. May I get a degree for folding? Now, my colleague with that, if you guys watch me on Better's Corner, you would have seen me folding my wrapper countless times. Like, I do it without stress. Okay, while the last hurdle was for them to drink a full bottle of water at a go. So, you know, there was a lot of confusion as to whether V needs to throw a ball or she needs to do this up until the buzzer went off. And my baby girl started crying as soon as she went back to her seat. You know, Neo was there cuddling her and telling her, it's fine, you tried. I mean, she really tried. This was her first time ever getting that close. So, I know how painful that can be. You guys, when you don't nearly reach the final bus stop, the contest you say the motor not go reach there, so you go need trek. That's in the pain. And you guys need to understand that this girl was just up for eviction on Sunday, so I knew that she really wanted that. She really wanted to get immunity. And of course, you guys know that if she had become head of house, obviously deputy would be who? New. You know, so that would have allowed their people rest from the whole voting thing and all of that. But oh well, she did not win. Congratulations to Ozo and Nengi once again. Now, something else I promised myself that better you must mention it here is the fact that when Ozo and Nengi stepped into the head of house lounge yesterday, guys, it was a complete mess. Complete mess. Like, Nengi was like, how can I be in my head of house lounge the first day and I have to arrange all of these things? Everything was just scattered. Not be them. Not them now. They don't scatter them. They go scatter them. Also, even had to go to the toilet area and was like, Nengi, you need to come and see this. I'm like, ah! Kidwaya and Erica don't turn the life of that HOH down upside down. These two people now had to start cleaning everywhere yesterday. I felt really bad. I was like, what kind of rubbish is this? Nengi mentioned that when she was head of house, before she left, she made sure to put the lounge in order. Ozo and Dorothy did the same thing before they left. So how come these two people? How come? Anyway, we know how come, so Mojo they go. And guys, I must commend most of the other housemates that have not been doing so well with the HOH tax before now. Yesterday, they all did well. I mean, Tricky T got to like 20-something for the first time. Tricky T that keeps rolling 1, 2, 3, before 6 go come, time don't nearly end. But yesterday was different, like he got really close. Watani got really close. I was like, what is going on? Today has to be a very good day for these people. But like I said, at the end of every competition, there's always one winner. So yes, it's the Ozone Week, guys. Let's see if they're going to win their wager task again. Because of course, the last time Ozo was head of house, they won their task. So let's watch and see if they're going to win it this week again. Let's also hope that he doesn't lose his cool this time. I just pray that the housemates coordinate, because if they don't coordinate, it will give them back. Hot. Okay? Anyways, guys, that's all the gist I have for you in this particular video. If you enjoyed watching it, please don't forget to give me a very big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, please. I know that the whole plea I did yesterday got to you people. A lot of people kept on telling me, oh, better I'll subscribe. This thing you talk now, I don't enter my body. Thank you so much for listening to my plea, oh. Thank you for subscribing. Let me just tell you, yeah, yesterday, just this yesterday way past, I got close to 1,000 subscribers. That means a lot. What? 1,000 in less than 24 hours. What? Bethans, you guys are the best. Thank you so much. I truly appreciate your love. I appreciate you being here. In fact, people were like soliciting subscribe. I particularly pinned somebody's comment in that last video. And somebody was like, why are you pinning this comment? I'm like, oh God, it helped me advertise my business. So why would I pin it? Why would I pin it? So anyways, guys, thank you so much. And I will definitely see you guys on the next one. All right? Bye, guys.